टुडेज टॉपिक इज अबाउट नालसा, नेशनल लीगल सर्विसेज अथॉरिटी. इट इज इन द न्यूज बिकॉज द रीसेंट लॉ कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया हैड रिकमेंडेड दैट द मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द नेशनल लीगल सर्विसेज अथॉरिटी विच इज टू प्रोवाइड फ्री सर्विसेज टू द अंडर प्रिविलेज्ड सेक्शंस इज नॉट वर्किंग इफेक्टिवली. So there is a need for amendment to the NALSA Act so that there should be a strict enforcement if there is no implementation of National Legal Services Authority. What is this National Legal Services Authority, NALSA? Rashtriya Kanuni Seva Pradhikaran. So it mainly talks about providing the legal services. Why? Because in a country like India, everyone cannot get the legal services. Why? Because the legal services are at urban areas. Means the courts are located in urban areas. The district courts are located in urban areas. The high courts are located in the capital cities. The Supreme Court of India is located at Delhi. So getting justice, asking for justice itself is a costly affair. Having an argument for the justice itself is a costly affair. Why? Because the argument will be made by the lawyers. The argument will be made by the advocates. There is a lot of difference between the lawyers and the advocates. Lawyers means they don't have any power to argue in the court. They have power only to make the petitions. Only writing power they have, the lawyers. Whereas advocates have the power to argue in the courts. So advocates, we have to use the correct word, which is called as advocates. So this advocates charge exorbitant prices. This advocates charge exorbitant interest rates, exorbitant charges. Apart from it, every time visiting a district court in district area, in district headquarters, or visiting a high court in the state capital, or visiting a national capital for the sake of Supreme Court is a very costly affair, mainly for socially and economically backward communities of the country. Mainly for the socially and economically backward communities of the country. But the Adhikaran, the constitution under Article 39 Clause A, the constitution under Article 39 Clause A says about providing free legal aid. Providing free legal aid to the communities who are socially and economically backward. So Constitution of India is also talking about free legal aid. Under this free legal aid, under this Article 39A, a law was been made in 1987, which is called as National Legal Services Authority Act of 1987. And this act is envisioning, providing free legal aid to the lowest of the society, like SC community, ST community, women who are unable to pay the charges for the services in the court. So that particular authority is called as National Legal Services Authority. This National Legal Services Authority is present in the Delhi national level, at state level also State Legal Services Authority is present, at district also there is District Legal Service Authority is present. This three service authority will be taking care about providing the free legal service to the to the people, to the communities who are unable to pay the amount, mainly socially and economically backward in districts, socially and economically backward in the states, socially and economically backward at the national level, in order to provide the free legal services. That is what the National Legal Services Authority of India talks about. See, Article 39A, free legal aid to the poor and weaker sections of the society and ensures justice for all. The major motto is justice for all. Providing justice for all, irrespective of their social status, irrespective of their economic status, everyone should get justice. In a society where the justice is denied, it is not called society, it is called as an chaos, chaotic society. So there is a need to ensure the justice for all. So justice for all can be ensured by this legal services authorities. Article 14 and Article 22 makes obligatory for the state to ensure equality before law and legal system which promotes justice on the basis of equal opportunity to all. Yes, everyone should be provided with equal justice. Everyone should be given equal opportunity for the justice. So, under the Constitution of India itself, mentioned under Article 39, Clause A, under Article 14, that equality of justice is also one of the criteria to ensure the justice. In 1987, Legal Services Authority of India Act was being made, which came into force on 9th November 1995 to establish a nationwide uniform network, for providing free and competent legal services to the weaker sections of the society on the basis of equal opportunity. So, everyone will be provided with equal opportunity in order to get the justice. That is the major motto of National Legal Services Authority. So, National Legal Services Authority is to provide free legal services. To provide free legal services, that to competent services. Competent services means skilled services, not just arguing in front of the court. They should also argue with the skill. A competent, see, it's not only about taking the case, no. If I take the case and if I don't argue, there is no question of taking the case. I have to take the case and I have to argue and I have to help the poor sections also. That is what the required. So, providing free legal services as well as competent services is the motto of Legal Services Authority of India. So, National Legal Services Authority has been constituted under Legal Services Authority of India Act of 1987. Why we want an NALSA? Next is why. Why NALSA? Why NALSA? Because everyone cannot bear the cost. The cost, it is very costly affair. Getting justice is a costly affair. Inaccessible. Why? Because the courts are located in urban areas. The poorest of the poor, the people who are living in the villages, the people who are in SC communities, ST communities, tribal people, they cannot go to the courts for the sake of justice. Hence, there is a need for a mechanism whereby the services need to be provided freely. And the services should be competent. Because of that, there is an inevitability that NALSA should come into existence. Hence, National Authority for Legal Services or National Legal Services Authority of India came into existence in 1987. So, why you are talking now? Recently, the Law Commission of India told that this National Legal Service Authority is not functioning effectively. There is a need for reinventing NALSA. There is a need for reforming the NALSA. In this context, I am discussing about NALSA. So, as the Law Commission has been discussed about it and the government also very serious in reforming this NALSA, hence it is a current affair. In every state, there will be a state legal service authority. In every high court, a high court legal service committee have been constituted. And at every district, there will be a district legal service authority. Taluk level service legal authority have been constituted. NALSA to provide free legal services to the people and to conduct Lok Adalats. Lok Adalat also I will be discussing now. So, mainly the concept is about providing the free legal services. Providing the free legal services for the poorest of the poor, weakest of the weak is the objective of NALSA. The free legal services include kya kya hai usme? Prelims point of view very important. The free legal services which include under the NALSA is number one, payment of court fee. Court fee will be there. That court fee also will be paid by the NALSA, not only advocate fee. Not only advocate fee, not only advocate services are free, but the court fee also will be given by the NALSA. The processing fee also will be paid by the NALSA. Service of lawyers in legal proceedings, obtaining and supply of certified copies, preparation of appeal and paper books, including printing and translation of documents into legal proceedings, the petitions, you know, I will tell you the cost to just make a petition. Just to make a petition, not arguing or not filing, just to make a legal document, just to make a preparation of a legal document, lawyers will charge 2000 rupees. Just to make a legal document of 3 papers, just to make a proper legal document of 2 to 3 papers, the lawyers will charge exorbitant interest, exorbitant prices. If it is high court, they will charge more. So, these all services will be waived off under National Legal Services Authority of Who are the eligible under NALSA? Women, children, SC, ST, industrial workmen, victims of mass disaster, victims of violence, victims of communalism, victims of regionalism, victims of ethnic conflicts, these victims, as well as disabled persons, as well as persons in custody. If, for example, I am in custody, no one is there to take care about me, no one is there to file on behalf of me, then the NALSA will be providing free services to me. Persons in custody also, the NALSA will be providing the services. Persons with annual income doesn't exceed rupees 1 lakh. In Supreme Court Legal Services Committee, the limit is 1,25,000. Victims of trafficking in human beings are bakery. So, these conditions are very important. Prelims point of view, we can expect that NALSA can provide services to whom? National Legal Services Authority can provide services to whom and why? This is about National Legal Services Authority of India. Hence, there is a recommendation from the Law Commission. This NALSA, how it is expected, it is not functioning according to its expectations. The poor people of the country, the vulnerable sections of the country, the weaker sections of the country are not getting the competent services. Hence, there is a need to relook into the National Legal Services Authority Act 1987. Hence, it's a current affair.